Hey, 42 here. More than 2,500 left-handed people are killed each year whilst using equipment designed for right-handed people, the most dangerous of which is the power saw. Life sure can be hard for a lefty. The word right is synonymous with the word correct, whereas left comes from Old English, where it meant sinister and evil. In Old England, left-handedness was actually believed to have come from the devil. So, if left-handedness is such a disadvantage, then why are between 10 and 12% of the population still left-handed? After all, evolution typically weeds out imperfections within a species. But scientists have found evidence that as far back as 500,000 years ago, 10% of humans were left-handed. It's always been this way. So there must still be some advantage to being left-handed, even in the modern world. So, what is it? Let's find out. Contrary to some theories, left-handedness is not learned as a child. It's not simply a matter of which hand the child chooses to write with from an early age. If this were true, the numbers would be closer to 50-50 for left and right-handedness, but only 10% of the population is left-handed. In fact, we can actually tell if a baby is going to be left or right-handed when they're only a couple of months old. When you place a baby on its tummy, babies who will grow up to be left-handed will typically turn their heads to the left, whereas right-handers will do the opposite. Now, before you go haphazardly flipping over babies to try this out for yourself, you should know it's not an entirely accurate way to tell, but research has shown there's a strong correlation there. So if we don't learn left-handedness, then where does it come from? Statistics suggest we're born with it. It's in our genes. Two right-handed parents have a 9% chance to give birth to a left-handed child. When one parent is left-handed, that rises to 19%, and when both parents are left-handed, the chance is 26%. These statistics suggest that handedness is at least somewhat hereditary. But left-handedness is highly unusual because it's not simply caused by dominant and recessive genes. About 90% of people are right-handed, suggesting that right-handedness is an extremely dominant trait. Based on what we know about genetics, a gene that is so fiercely dominant, in this case right-handedness, would have forced a recessive gene, left-handedness, out of the gene pool altogether a long, long time ago. In theory, we shouldn't have left-handed people anymore, yet we still do. And the percentage of people that are born left-handed isn't decreasing like it theoretically should do. In fact, it has stayed exactly the same for thousands of years. This suggests that handedness isn't caused by a simple case of dominant versus recessive genes. It's considerably more complex than that. It's likely to be caused by a whole mix of different genes, or perhaps something completely different altogether. The truth is that why some people prefer one hand over the other is still a bit of a mystery. There is one theory, however, that is the most commonly accepted answer to this perennial question. Researchers think handedness is actually caused by something called brain lateralization. Our brains are divided into two hemispheres, left and right. For the sake of efficiency, our brains like to use different regions for different tasks. Two of the most energy-intensive activities that humans do are language and using our fine motor skills. So our brain clusters the control of those activities into one side of our brain, rather than having it spread out all over the damn place. This makes those tasks more energy efficient. Most people's language and fine motor skills are controlled by the left hemisphere of their brain, and each hemisphere generally controls the opposite side of the body. So it makes sense that most people would be right-handed, because in most people, the majority of the processing which controls the movement of muscles is done in the left hemisphere of their brain, which is the hemisphere of the brain that controls the right side of the body. In fact, in 90% of right-handed individuals, they use the left hemisphere of their brain to control language and fine motor skills. Whereas a considerably lower 61% of left-handers control these skills using the left side of their brain. In most animals, the hemispheres of their brain divide the processing of tasks equally. Those same animals have no hand preference, whereas human brains tend to specialize functions to either one side of the brain or the other, and consequently, we also favor a particular hand. This strong correlation has led biologists to think that brain lateralization is closely linked to handedness. Left hemisphere brain lateralization is a common trend amongst left-handers, but it doesn't fully explain why people are left-handed to begin with. After all, 61% of left-handers still use the left hemisphere of their brain, the same side that right-handers use. Researchers at Pennsylvania State University believe handedness is caused by genes. Their theory is that there are two distinct alleles of a gene which cause handedness. An allele is a variation of a gene. One of those alleles is known as the D gene, which stands for dextral, meaning right. The other allele is called the C gene, which stands for chance. The D gene is the most common in the human gene pool, and when it is present, the person will always be right-handed. You may therefore think that the presence of the significantly less common C gene will mean the person is left-handed. But it's known as the chance gene because when it's present, the hand preference of the person will be random. There will be a 50-50 chance of the person being left or right-handed. This means that there's a third class of handedness. There's a small percentage of people who have some degree of ambidexterity. Being ambidextrous means one is equally as proficient with both hands. Since genes come in pairs, every human has one of three combinations of the aforementioned D and C genes. The first combination is DD, meaning the person has a strong right-handed bias. The second combination is CC, meaning there's a straight-up 50-50 chance the person will be either left or right-handed. But the third combination is quite unusual. The third possibility is DC, meaning they have one of each gene variation. People with both a D, right-handed, and a C, chance gene, are usually most proficient with their right hand, but they are also perfectly capable using their left hand. People who have a DC gene combination are somewhere in the spectrum of being semi-ambidextrous to fully ambidextrous. Such people make up only 1% of the population. So if you are one of the 1% that can adequately use both hands, well done, you have a very rare set of genes. But if you are left-handed, it's not all bad news. There's numerous benefits to being a lefty. Lefties are sought after in competitive sports. Since most players are right-handed, a lefty can surprise and unnerve their opponent, gaining the advantage. Because most players are used to fighting right-handed opponents, not left-handers. Sports where left-handers have such an advantage include tennis, baseball, and boxing, to name but a few. Also, scientists aren't quite sure why, but lefties are considerably more likely to be a genius than righties. For example, 20% of Mensa members are left-handed, which is a disproportionately large amount when you consider that only 10% of the population are left-handed. Some believe lefties are more intelligent because throughout their life they've been forced to use and work out both sides of their brain instead of just the one side. Also, an unusually high percentage of US presidents have been left-handed too, including Barack Obama, Bill Clinton, George H.W. Bush, and Ronald Reagan. There are endless benefits to being a lefty. So even if the word left is synonymous with being evil, don't worry. Next time your friend teases you for being a lefty, just remind them that you're considerably more likely to be accepted into Mensa and you stand a much better chance than they do at becoming president. Thanks for the view, subscribe for more 42.